Hello everyone, this video is in continuation to our videos on Animal Kingdom. In our last video, we have discussed about chondrichthyes. In this video, we'll talk about the examples of chondrichthyes. I've written the various examples. We'll talk about them one by one. You can watch the video till the end. In the end, you will get all the important pointers on the board. You can use them for your notes. Fine. First one, the first example of chondrichthyes, a very common example of chondrichthyes is scolyodon. Scolyodon has some significant features. One is they have five pair of gill slits, which are uncovered. That means not covered with operculum. So this is a very significant feature of scolyodon. Plus, scolyodon has very large dorsal fin. In the structure, in the diagram which we have drawn in previous video, we have made the dorsal fin. This dorsal fin in case of scolyodon is very, very large. That is why when a shark is swimming through the sea, we can clearly see the dorsal fin upward if it's moving above on the surface. Plus, they are surface feeders, so they need to come up. So the dorsal fin is clearly visible. So the dorsal fin in case of scolyodon is very large. Plus, they have a liver with large amount of oil, and this liver oil is extracted to make medicines, or I'll directly write, to cure many skin diseases. Fine. So why do they have this oil in the liver? Because they don't have air bladders in them, which are there in the bony fish. Fine. So when they don't have air bladders, this liver is made up. They have to, you know, keep their fins moving continuously. Their fins should keep lashing, moving continuously, which help them in swimming. So they have to keep swimming. Their fins need to keep moving. So in order to provide energy, their liver has large amount of oil present in it, which is extracted by us to make various medicines to cure different diseases, specifically some skin diseases. So these are the main features about scolyodon. The next type of next type of chondrichthyes fish is torpedo. We have discussed about torpedo or electric ray in our previous video also. This is known as electric ray, and a very significant feature about torpedo is they have electric glands, or you can say paired electric glands, which generate electricity, fine, to prevent them from the predators. Then is the next example, trigon, which is a stingray, also a type of ray, which is called stingray. Then we have the next very, very important example, chimera. Now, this chimera, why is it so important? Because it is a connecting link. It is a connecting link. And we know what are connecting links, which have characteristic features of two groups. So, it's a connecting link between chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. Fine, and its connecting link has features of both. So when we talk about chondrichthyes, the specific feature of chondrichthyes which it possesses is its endoskeleton. That means endoskeleton is made up of cartilage. Whereas osteichthyes, when we talk about, so it has four gill slits covered by operculum. Otherwise, in all the other fish, the gill slits are not covered by operculum, but in the case of chimera, the gill slits are covered with operculum, which is a covering, and it is a bony fish characteristic. Next is Zygaena or hammerheaded shark. Herein, if you remember, the head is divided, or you can say it is in the shape of a hammer, just to, you know, same help it to fight against the predators. Now, this type, Zygaena, is viviparous. that means give rise to its offsprings. So when it is viviparous, has to give rise to, give birth to the babies, so it has a placenta also, and the type of placenta present here is yolk sac placenta. Fine, because it has to give birth to the young ones, so they need nourishment inside the body, so they have placenta, and the type of placenta is yolk sac. This is a distinctive feature. Then is pristis or sawfish. Pristis, in this the rostrum or the front part of the snout or rostrum, snout which is known as rostrum, is in the form of a saw, like this. This is the snout. And then we have the fish. You must have seen this fish also on various Discovery channels. Sawfish. So we'll write rostrum like a saw. And also they are viviparous. Viviparous, and obviously they have a placenta, which is also yolk sac placenta. Fine. Significant feature about Pristis. Rhinodon is the last type, and it is the largest shark. The feature is that it is the largest shark, Rhinodon. Fine. So these are the examples of chondrichthyes. We have discussed Collodon, Tripedo, Trigon, Chimera, Zygaena, Pristis and Rhinodon. These are the examples of chondrichthyes. In our next video, we'll start with the bony fish, that is Osteichthyes. So keep watching, liking, sharing, subscribing. Thank you.